Welcome to video number 22 on working with train controller. In the previous video we had a look how we can accomplish different speeds for different trains in one and the same block, and in this video we're going to do something similar, but now we're going to have a look how we can get different stop positions for different trains in one and the same block. Over here, this is my personal layout that I'm still working on, by the way. It's never finished, of course. And what we like to accomplish is that over here we have a blue intercity train, a long one. I want it to drive to Station West Platform 4 and make a stop in the middle of that platform. Then I have a yellow intercity train that is also going to move to platform number 4, but it is a very short train. But still, I also want that to stop in the middle of the platform, which means then that its nose stops at a completely different position than the blue train did. And then we have a cargo train over here, and also that is going to drive to west platform 4, but it is not going to make a scheduled stop. It is a drive-through, but the block ahead will be occupied, so it needs to stop. But in this case I want it to stop at the very end of the block and not in the middle of the platform. And the question is, how can we accomplish something like this? Let's go into edit mode and let's first have a look at these train specifications. The intercity train, the blue one, has a length of 100 centimeters. Yes, obviously we need to specify a train length, otherwise having a stop in the middle of the platform will not work. Train controller needs to calculate now where it needs to stop, so it needs to have the train length to be successful. We have the yellow intercity train, and that is a very short one for the purpose of the demo, only one locomotive with 22 centimeters of length. And the cargo train also has a length, but that's not important because it's meant to stop here at the end of the platform. Well, then we have a look at the block itself, and it has only one sensor. At the very beginning of the block there's a read switch and there are magnets under the train. And yeah, I want this stop marker to be in the middle and this one to be at the end of the block. So that looks good. And I click that stop marker, and over here, I already made this drawing. Over here we can see that this stop marker is in this drop down is selected middle of the train. The alternatives are head of the train, which is the default. You can also do the tail of the train or even your own formula. I think you can give percentages or something. This all obviously works only if you have specified the train length. Then also the brake marker is specified for the middle of the train. Yeah, you need to specify both or strange effects may happen. Then the other set is meant for the cargo train, and that is specified for the head of the train, and also the stop marker obviously for the head of the train. You may ask, by the way, how do you get multiple markers? Well, just like any one marker, you click first the sensor, then simply click the marker and it will add a new one, and you can drag it up or down to give it a position that is distinguishable from the others. So this is as simple as we have made now a third set of markers in a few seconds. And then of course you click them and specify their distances over here, and that's all that's there to it. Let me delete those, otherwise maybe strange things are going to happen later on in the video. Now the question arises, how can we distinguish between the different trains or maybe different schedules? Well, that can be done by double clicking the marker. A double click that opens up the marker properties window, where again we have a whole lot of tabs that we can make all kinds of choices, and I'm interested now in the trains tab, and there I have selected the intercity trains. All intercity trains will listen to this brake marker. In a previous video we had a look how we can create these train groups, and I did that obviously for my two cargo trains and my two intercity trains to make the selection as easy as possible. So this is the intercity trains, and then the stop marker also is only valid for the intercity trains. Again, you need to do both the brake and the stop marker, otherwise strange effects may happen. Then we go to the marker for the cargo trains. Yeah, well, that's the in that train top the cargo trains are selected, and also in the stop marker the cargo trains are selected. One more thing that I would like to mention. I selected the trains, but there's an alternative. We could also have selected schedules. That may be dependent on the situation or the task that you would like to accomplish if you choose for schedules or for trains. Maybe it's also a personal preference, it depends. But the possibility is there. You can have a marker valid for certain trains or have a marker valid for certain schedules. Well, let's get out of here, and let's get out of here, and let's now have a look how we can see what is happening. There's a pop-up video. Well, there. Let's wait with the pop-up video. Let me first put the trains on a drag and drop schedule so that I do not have that much work later on with the video. Let me put this one already on a schedule to there, but it has entered that schedule, but it cannot drive yet because all the blocks are occupied. Let me also already put this yellow train over there. So now when I put the blue train into the station, the others will automatically follow already. Yeah, the pop-up video is here, and let me now start this blue train. There it goes. It's going to drive into Station West. In the upper right corner of the video, it should be possible to see it moving now. By the way, the three wooden crates on the track are the left one is the end of the block, so that's the one where the cargo train should stop. Then the middle crate is the nose of the blue train, but actually it's stopping at the rightmost crate. That is the middle of the train. So we can now perfectly see in the video what is happening and which train is stopping where. It's already slowing down, as we can see. And yeah, it obviously is going to put its nose somewhere around that middle crate. But the important point is the rightmost crate. That should be somewhere between those two wagons over there. A little bit further, because the locomotive is a bit shorter. Well, I think that worked perfectly well. The other train, the yellow train, is already on the way and should enter the video more or less maybe right now. I'm going to put away this blue train so that the yellow train can enter. Oh, that is not a path, that is valid, that is stupid. That was a little mistake. I have to go over here. Yes, as soon as the yellow train has stopped, has come to a full stop. By the way, over here is a new train counter. It tells me that now two trains are running. That means the cargo train is also running and the yellow train has stopped. Yeah, let me put the yellow train on a schedule to this station, and then we can see. Yes, it's already there. Blue train is out of the way right now, and now the yellow train will enter. And then we will see if it stops also at the middle of the platform, which again is the rightmost crate on this video. Yeah, it's of course never reaching a high speed because it just ramped up its speed and now it's already ramping down its speed again. Cargo train is already on the move outside the video, but it should pop up in let's say 10 seconds at the corner. Yeah, the yellow train is nice and neat stopping at that crate that is the middle of the platform. Yeah, that worked perfectly well. I'm happy with this result. You see that the nose of the train is completely at a different location as the blue train, because that was at the middle crate. So a train controller is doing these calculations quite nice for us. We only had to select a middle of the platform from a drop-down list. It's as easy as that. Right, the cargo train is still on its schedule, but almost came to a halt. That will be 5 seconds, and then right now, and I will put it on a schedule to the station. It is normally a drive-through. It should not stop there. But since the block ahead is occupied now by my yellow intercity, The cargo train has to stop, but it will do that at the end of the block, which is at the leftmost crate. Well, if we have seen that happening, then I am happy. It means that actually it is not quite difficult to get all these kinds of different stop positions in one block for different trains. Of course, that middle of the train one, that's a quite powerful one, because no matter how long your train is, it will always nicely stop there. There's only one thing you need to do. Well, it's stopping nicely at the end of the block, and well, this demonstrates how this works out in real life. Next video, that will be about graphics. Maybe you already noticed that there are some graphics over here. I can start schedules with a nice button, and I can also start schedules here with these buttons. There are schedule counters and train counters and what have we. Well, the next video will be a little bit about how we can get these kinds of graphics done. Maybe see you back there. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.